I love roguelike games. Risk of Rain 2 or Blazing Beaks are some of my favorite games of all time. I quite enjoy the hard difficulty and the extremely satisfying and rewarding gameplay of roguelike games. If you perhaps don't know what roguelike is, it's simply a game with permadeath and random level generation. Basically, when dying, you lose all your progress and have to start a new run with new random levels. Meaning you won't get bored by repeating levels, and the game is more based around your actual skill rather than memorizing level layouts. This sounds great, you might say, but random level generation is way more complicated than you might think, and making such a game is extremely challenging. And that's why I decided to work on a 2D roguelike game on my own. The concept of the game is a bit inspired by Risk of Rain, so you go through levels by defeating a boss in each stage and collect upgrades along the way. You play as a character who has a bow and arrows and some other cool abilities. The upgrade system should be similar to a deck building game, so upgrades can be combined in certain ways to make them more powerful. I will probably adjust this concept along the way, and this idea isn't set in stone, but I just want to get into development and start working. As usually, I began by creating the player and his movement. In this project, I really wanted to focus on reusability of my code, so I wouldn't have to rewrite a lot of stuff, which saves time. This allows me to use the same basic behavior from the player for the enemies and bosses and so on. Next, I added a little red thing that resembles my enemy for now. It checks if the player is in range and in line of sight and then starts moving towards you. Of course, the next logical step was to give the player a way to damage and kill enemies. I gave the player bow and arrow mechanics, but there is no bow, so it's actually just arrow mechanics. And look, he can now shoot arrows at enemies, wow. The cool thing is that the player can change the strength of the shot by holding and letting go of the button. A fully charged shot indicated by this circle around the player makes the arrow deal more damage and also increase its size. On the other side, spamming the button will result in more but less powerful arrows. And for really skilled gamers, there's a way to shoot a much more powerful arrow with crit damage. This can be achieved by releasing the button while the arrow is charged half. It creates a higher skill ceiling and makes shooting arrows definitely more fun. But the timing window is extremely tiny and hard to hit. Or maybe I'm just bad and can't really see the button at the right time. But it should work, trust me. In this project, I really wanted to test out the new input system in Unity. It makes coding input quite different and more efficient. But it's definitely harder to wrap your head around. I mean, look at this. Pass-through, value, and context, and these weird arrows, okay? However, the cool thing is that it's very easy to add controller support. You just add a new binding, choose the key, and mark it as gamepad. And that's practically it. Playing with a controller is also the reason why I suck so hard at aiming in this clip. I surely need to add some sort of aim assist later on. Recently, I played a game called Snake RX, or however you want to pronounce it. It has a very cool effect when damaging an enemy. The enemies shrink in size very smoothly and go back to the original size slowly. I really wanted to reproduce this animation, but Unity's animation system is so terrible when creating simple animations like that because it locks the value it's animating even when it's not on. I really don't like it. So I created a class which holds a value which can be animated through script. I don't want to bore you with the exact details, but it simply lets me smoothly change a value by adding a velocity to it. It works perfectly, and now it's easy to add a simple and smooth animation. Like for example, I can just add this line of code to the shoot function of the player and he now grows in size when shooting. I would really like to know what you think about these animations. Let me know in the comments. Next, I added some camera shake when enemies die to make it feel more impactful. But as you can see, or better, can't see, it's really hard to notice the camera shake because the background is flat and has only one color. To easily fix this, I made a particle system in the background and added a parallax effect I stole from my last game I made for a game jam. I also was tired of seeing these enemies just plop out of existence when they die. So I made a particle effect for that as well. And look at this, the game already looks more alive. I was also tired of seeing this red rectangle as my enemy and the white thing as my player. So I spent some time creating graphics for both in Adobe Illustrator. Now the player has an actual bow which loads and shoots the arrows with a satisfying animation. And the enemy looks like a shrimp with only one eye, but he can finally attack the player with a cool animation. I tried to make the graphics look simple and minimalist, but still interesting and detailed. Let me know what you think about them in the comments down below. Lastly, I wanted to test out my enemy script structure, which should, in theory, allow me to create new enemies with no problem. A new enemy I wanted to add was a faster but weaker enemy with the ability to jump towards the player and deal a good chunk of damage. This, of course, turned out to be a bit harder than expected, and I had to add an ability script to make the jump possible. This is what the new enemy now looks like. A blue and thin rectangle with less health but dangerously high damage. If you have any ideas for a new enemy concept, I would love to read them in the comments down below. But this is pretty much everything I worked on over the last few weeks. If you enjoyed the video and want to follow my progress on this game, consider subscribing and liking this video. I hope you have a great day and see you next time.